Hey y'all, it's Terry here from Treetop Woodworking, and just I need to change blades today on my saw, and I thought I had two new blades. Well, I got one blade that looks new, and that's a real fine finishing blade. That one looks new. But this in here, the one I'm needing, my rip blade, well, it don't look new. But I'm going to put it on and see if it does any better than the one that's on it. We'll try it out anyway. I was looking at this wood I got, you know, and you would think this darker one here would be the red oak, wouldn't you? But actually, that ain't got nothing to do with it. This is the white oak. This red oak here, it has to do with the pores being open, and then ones on this one, well, being pretty well shut off. You can see basically there isn't none, but you had to zoom in to really see. But anyway, which would make white oak a better furniture wood for outside work if you was doing it. But I got some wood the other day. I got some white oak. And I got the red oak here. But on the very bottom down there, I got some good looking walnut. And there was a boy passed away, and his wife was going through his stuff. And that's what. That was some of his treasure there, that good walnut there. I'll show it to you a close up here in a few days. But yeah, it's some really nice looking wood. Yeah, I may make a mallet ends or something with that. I'm not sure. Use the oak I got for some handles. I got a big old beam of oak standing outside, like 8-10 feet tall. I'm gonna be using for handles. But anyway, have to forgive me. I got this new thing to try to hold and my phone for me and make videos, but it's kind of right in front of me where I can't see what I'm doing unless I look in the camera. And looks can be deceiving on camera. But it might give y'all a little better view of things. Like of the Diary of a Madman mess I got here. Yeah, I got wood piled everywhere. Everywhere. You can see a little bit of it here. I mean, it's all underneath this too. Just pile everywhere. Got some up here above my head. And like I say, got it everywhere. Let's see if I can't get this cranked up as far as we go. First thing we need to do. Pull the deal out. This is gonna take me a minute. When I edit this video, I'll probably speed through this process. I had a screwdriver on me. I'd go ahead and. Well, I think the whole time that wasn't recording. What I did, most of these, like I say, have the tools underneath this. Underneath this. Right here, but mine didn't. They got one you can grab a hold here, nothing there, I believe. But mine didn't, so I took a crescent wrench and put it on. I stuck a piece of wood down in here, and I brung it, the wrench towards me this way, and it grabbed the board, and I was able to break it loose. But still be careful, because you don't want to hit that, and you got this big nut to take off there. But this is a Ryobi 10-inch here, too. And it, again, if anybody knows, if I might be able to use a dado on this, you see what I have there to work with. If anybody has used one on this saw, again, a Ryobi 10-inch. Just let me know in the comments, please. But and like I say, if this blade doesn't do any better. I'll be I wonder if I gotta take my thing off to get that. Let me get this spacer off, maybe. That'll help me. But I hope I don't gotta take my writhing knife off. I might have to. Having a hard enough time just getting a hold of this little spacer. There we go. About got the spacer. Make sure I put it in right too. Assist with the bevel. Facing out. Okay. Now maybe the blade will come off. I may have to turn it the right way though. Oh, I may have to take that off. Let me look at this a little bit closer. I can't do nothing with this camera right in my face hardly, but I'll let you know what I had to do here in a minute. So, well, actually, I didn't have to take that off. I just slid right out around, and I was able to just take it right off. But my Riley knife looked like it'd been easy to take off anyway. It's got the little spinner there. You can probably loosen up and get it off by hand. But
don't know if I had to, but it seems like it made it easier to loosen the Riley knife.
I'm going to put on. But I know I have hit some nails with my head. And I think this was a 24 tooth. Yeah. I think the one I'm putting on is a 40-something. I don't know. I might have to get me another blade anyway because I want one for ripping. And this other one's about 40-something teeth. And I think that's just too many for the job that's going to have to be done. And like I say, this blade, it looks worse than the one I'm taking off, but you never know till you get down there and give her a whirl, I guess. See if we don't turn it backwards. Needs to go on right like this. Yeah, this blade looks a lot better, don't it? Yep. Anyway, I'm going to slide this on. Probably won't get to try it out tonight, but we'll have it ready for in the morning. Wasn't planning on it, but very well. Might as well make a short video of it. Maybe somebody well, do I need to adjust my ain't holding my mouth right or something? Well, don't really know what was the problem. I guess I just wasn't holding my mouth right. So finally, it just slipped right on, but I did get a piece of wood I know that was hanging it off, a little piece that was down in here. So that may have been drove off a little low, but wouldn't take much. Then we got to get these pieces on and the bevel out. Drop it here. But now, you see, kind of wish I did have that tool for holding this. But See, Mike, I did use VyScripts once before. I should have seen what size that was before I got this on. Go ahead and crank this down as far as it goes. And I don't think you gotta put the death grip on these to keep them on there either. Just gotta get them on there pretty decent. Probably hold the blade with your hand. Get hold of it here. And that's probably good enough there. But we'll give her a whiz tomorrow. And again, let me get in here. If you think I can use a dado with this saw, just let me know. Again, it's a Ryobi 10 inch. But we'll give her a whirl in the morning and see what we get with it. Can't see nothing with this phone in my face. But maybe give y'all a little better view. I may have to let my blade all the way down if I can get this in easy. There we go. Just had to lift that one in. There we go. Shut it off, did I? But that's all we'll do to it for tonight. We'll give her a whirl in the morning to see what's going on. And we'll finish this video up. But still, I just know I'm going to go get me another blade. Well, I may have to test this out inside here. It's a raining and we're having to be inside, so our lights may go dim. And being honest with you, I had forgot to tighten my writhing knife down. But I took care of that before I ever started it up. I was lucky enough to remember. Remember to tighten your writhing knife down, and I hope you got one. Because I think those are the safest things there ever was. One of the best things ever was. I'd hate to. I really wouldn't want to run a saw without one of those. And you would can still tighten up, but you see it coming. You can feel it too, and you can take care of that before it ever becomes a problem, hopefully. But this is an old blade here again, and I'm just going to see if it's any better than my older one. If not, I got a newer one in town today. I think it's a 40 tooth. And I wanted to get a 20 something, but it was out today. But I think that and I do for now. But we're going to try this one out first and see what happens. better than the old one. The one that run it, I'll run that one for a while. But like I say, that was just a test. Well, as you can see, it's starting to rain again. They're giving rain for a couple days. Sun's shining and it's driving to rain. But I do have a project coming up I think you'll like, and I can't wait to get to it. But as for today in this little test here, I thank y'all for watching. And sure would appreciate it if you like, subscribe, comment, share. But I'll see y'all a little further around the mountain.